and then pull up for a wing over. That's a great photographic opportunity as well. And you can hear the pilots jutting on the throttle there as they do that to stay in position. And now if you didn't have your cameras ready in time for that manoeuvre, you've got to get them ready for this next one, which is the looping bomb burst. So pulling up, showing this aircraft in plan view, pulling over the top, and then bomb bursting on the way down.
Master on the Wessex helicopter in Northern Ireland. In 1990, he then retrains the pilot and flew the Chipmunk, Jet Provost, Hawk, Tucano and Harrier aircraft before retraining to the Tutor. Flying Andy Command's number 115 Squadron and Royal Air Force Wittering training qualified pilots to be flying instructors. Now as that half horizontal to your left is completed, Andy will offset this barrel roll to fly away from you before performing a stall turn. Today, the Tutor is flown by the Royal Air Force's largest flying school, number 6 Flying Training School. The Tutor is used to train junior army.
Topside view of the aircraft. Those hard points underneath the wing are cock tanks for extended range. And talking about Yuri Gagarin in space, can I commend you the film Hidden Figures, which is all about NASA in the National Aeronautics and Space Administration in the early 60s at the time of getting the first man into space, competing with the Russians. And it's a real story of about the prejudices that existed against females and against people of colour as well. It is a great film. Hidden Figures. So this isn't Yuri Gagarin who is flying this aircraft. It is Kenneth Arkwila, who is actually the man behind Planet Knight. This aircraft is the duty aircraft this weekend. That's 15-minute readiness, but as I was saying earlier, they can get airborne. They usually do get airborne a lot more quickly than that. And then at in the hours of darkness, 45-minute readiness. Again, they tend to get quick airborne a lot quicker than that. And as you can see there, one of the lifeboat crew recovered up to the airplane. Degree line there, spoke up at the top, diving down for half a loop. An aerobatic display is all about energy management. The full use of the energy that you've got, you can
kinetic energy converting height to speed to set up for the next maneuver. There's a tail slide through her smoke trail, puts out the nose, and her head's back down as she dives down towards the sea. On the upper wing. Teams in the 70s, 80s and 90s. Those of you who have been coming to air shows for a while may remember the Rothmans aerobatic teams, who at their height operated 10 aircraft, one four-ship team in the Far East, one four-ship team in the UK, and also a solo aircraft and a spare. Those are all the two-seater S2As. The UK team was led by the famous aviator Max Kelly. Then in the 1980s, when operates under Quayle, sponsorship of Team Quayle. The front of the aircraft, the tip, is a fabric aircraft, and that's why you can see any red or blue smoke that's caused by. Showing us the underside view of the aircraft. So you can see the tip tanks on the end of the engine tip. Hard points under the tip of the engine, which is So the Jet Provost was the basic The Strike Master was the export version of the Jet Provost trainer. So it fulfilled the dual role of training aircraft, but also powered and redesigned slightly to be configured for the light ground attack environment. They probably wouldn't have had the landing light on at that point, or been operating on a smoke system. But there we can see that nice plan view again, just as Mark rolls the aircraft.
Received its full permit to fly at the end of 2014. So
2015 was her first display season, and as you can imagine, she's been a very popular addition to the Air Show circuit. That original serial number, L6739, was an aircraft.
Squadron Leader Mark Disco Disco.